Hello students, next topic is cells in series. So in the series connection, this is cells connected in series, that is more than one cells connected in series. So in this case, it is similar to the resistors connected in series. So for the resistors in series, how do you say that the EMF is total EMF is equal to sum of the EMF dropped at each resistor, right? Similarly, the voltage here, it is called as for batteries, you're going to take it as EMF. So EMF of the battery, total EMF in the circuit is equal to sum of the EMF of each batteries. And the current is same current. Okay. So when does the current flows in the circuit? When you connect an external resistance. So I have an external resistance R here, and n number of batteries are connected in series. For series connection, the connection would be negative terminal of first battery will be connected to the positive terminal of the second cell or second battery, and again negative terminal of the second battery to the positive terminal of the third battery, and negative terminal of the third to positive terminal of the fourth, and the free end of the free positive terminal of the first cell and the free positive negative terminal of the last cell will be taken for the connection as the terminals of battery. And here, EMF of each battery is same because the battery value is same. So, EMF of each battery is same. That is psi, psi, psi. So, when you connect such kind of n number of batteries, then the total EMF would be n psi. So, EMF of each cell, R is the external resistance connected here. So, for the series connection, as I said, EMF is nothing but sum of the EMF of each batteries. So, total EMF is equal to psi plus psi as it goes on n till n. N, how many number of batteries you connect, that much number of psi's. So, psi plus psi plus psi, it goes on till n. And you can simply write this as n psi. This is total EMF for this connection. And then for a battery, if you consider a battery, you need to consider two things, which is EMF and the internal resistance. So we have got the EMF here, then the internal resistance of each battery would be small r. So I have n number of batteries here, then the total internal resistance for n battery would be n into r. And so we have EMF and the internal resistance. So three things we have to connect in every equation, that is current, voltage and resistor. So we have resistors for internal resistance and EMF as the voltage and the current. So current is equal to, we know the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, that is voltage is equal to current into resistor. Instead of voltage here for the battery case, you're going for EMF is equal to current I into internal resistance of the battery plus the external resistance. This is what is the formula. So from this, I'm going to take for the current. Current I is equal to EMF by bring this R to the other side, it becomes R plus R. So this is nothing but current I is equal to total EMF of the all batteries in series divided by total resistance. Internal resistance of each battery and the external resistance. So it is total resistance. So we have calculated this total EMF as n psi and divided by total resistances, total internal resistance of all batteries plus the external resistance. So total internal resistance is n into small r plus the external resistance here is r. So this r. So this is my current value in the series connection. We have the, so if you go for series connection, how the connection would be, you have to indicate, and then you have to calculate the current, voltage and resistance. So we have got voltage, that is EMF, resistance and the current value. So in this case, for the you can have two cases possible. Case A is if the internal resistance of the each battery is very much lower, so this part is negligible, so nr is not considerable, then the equation would become I is equal to n psi by simply external resistance r. And we know that, see, V is equal to ir, right? So V is equal to IR or sigma, I mean psi is equal to I into R. So psi, I is equal to psi by R. This part is nothing but the current I already we have one I, so let this be I1 for the one battery. Okay, so it is N into I1 for each case. And then case B, the case B, when the internal resistance is greater than the external resistance, that is each of the battery will have more of the internal resistance, then in that case capital R is negligible and this part is added. So I is equal to N psi by N R. If you cancel the N, it will be psi by R simply. See, psi by R is nothing but simply like one for single cell. For single cell, see, for single cell it is voltage is nothing but EMF is equal to I into single cell resistance, right? So for single cell, how do you write? The current I is equal to single EMF by single R. This is what we have got here. So if you connect N number of batteries also, if the internal resistance of each battery is higher, then if you connect N how many number of batteries also, it will be equal to the single cell, and no use of connecting N number of cells in series in that case. I hope you have understood. We shall go in for the cells in parallel in the next video. Thank you.